Now I'd like to introduce our incoming chairman of the board, John Taft, who is the CEO of RBC Wealth Management U.S. John has spent nearly 30 years in the industry, working at various financial institutions, including Piper Jaffray and Dougherty Summit Securities. Prior to becoming CEO, John served as head of asset management and products for RBC's U.S. and international division, and as CEO of Voyager Asset Management. John has been a very active member within SIFMA, having previously served as chair of the Private Client Steering Committee. During the early stages of regulatory reform debate, John helped lead SIFMA's support of a new federal fiduciary standard to govern both investment advisors and broker-dealers who provide personalized investment advice to retail advisors. As chairman of SIFMA's board, John will continue that leadership role on the issues I've already discussed and many more our industry will face over the next year. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please join me in welcoming John Taft?
Thank you, Tim. Good morning, everyone. 235 rulemakings, 41 reports, 71 studies authored by 11 different federal agencies, bureaus, and the Government Accountability Office. That's what Dodd-Frank requires be accomplished over the next 2 to 5 years. This massive undertaking, the single largest delegation of rulemaking authority by Congress to regulators in modern history, is a daunting task. But fortunately, in contrast to last fall and last spring, work on Dodd-Frank has become somewhat less political. During the legislative phase of financial regulatory reform, we all listened to and witnessed a lot of misinformation, heated rhetoric, and even anger. Now we've moved from a hot medium to a cool one, from rhetoric to analysis, from emotion to fact, and from political theater to operating realities. This is where SIFMA can and must step up and provide the critical input regulatory bodies need to write these rules. Frankly, as Tim said on the video earlier, our biggest fear is that regulators will be overwhelmed by the assignment. Not because there aren't good, smart people working there, but there simply aren't enough of them. And many of these agencies are being asked to take an oversight role that is outside of anything they've done in the past. There's simply not a legacy of core competency around certain issues. They need help. They know they need help, and believe it or not, they welcome our help. So we're doing everything we can to provide fact-based, content-rich analysis, to provide the expertise required to create rules that will help the financial services industry do what we do best when we stay focused on and remain true to our mission, which is to help facilitate and foster economic growth, something our country desperately needs right now. As your chair-elect for the past year, I'm proud of the way SIFMA embraced responsible financial reform from the very outset of the Dodd-Frank debate. SIFMA was then and continues to be a leading advocate for reform, but reform that balances the creation of a safer, sounder, more secure financial system with the recognition that that system is critical to economic growth. In order to achieve that balance, we need to help regulators write rules that prevent the broad and deep contagion that infected the entire system 2 years ago without inhibiting the ability of our financial institutions to promote economic growth. Does Dodd-Frank do that? We simply don't know yet. Certainly, in broad strokes, that was its intent. Some new rules are coming down extremely fast. The CFTC wants new regulations governing derivatives written by Christmas. But this phase of regulatory reform shouldn't just be about meeting rulemaking deadlines. It should be about getting it right. We need to get it right. The stakes are simply too high for anything less. Poorly crafted regulations could have unintended consequences that constrain capital formation, increase the cost of capital, make it harder for end users to hedge risks, or even increase systemic risk, which is the exact opposite of the intent of Dodd-Frank. Well, how is SIFMA responding? I think Tim did an excellent job of describing our activities on your behalf. What I'd like to do is just touch briefly on the priority he mentioned and you saw in the video earlier. These are the seven big areas of focus for SIFMA now and in the coming year. Systemic risk, resolution authority, derivatives regulation, securitization, capital and liquidity requirements, Volcker rule, and a new fiduciary standard of care. And those are just the primary areas SIFMA is addressing. Add to that the fact that these and other new regulations need to work with existing global regulations and will need to coordinate with rules still evolving overseas. The good news is we have the expertise within SIFMA, our staff, our board, our members, and we will commit the necessary resources to provide regulators with the guidance, data, facts, and intellectual content they need to get it right. Here's my ask of all of you. Get involved. Understand how we've organized and how we're mobilizing. Join the committee that represents your particular area of expertise. If you can't make that kind of commitment, then communicate with committee members. You don't have to know who to call. Just call who you know. Send us your thoughts on how we can most effectively operationalize Dodd-Frank. Remember, this is an evolving process. Follow the rulemaking with us. Every commentary we post, we provide to regulators will be posted the day it's submitted to the newly redesigned SIFMA.org website. And remember also, this is a messy process, but it is the process that will create the rules we will operate under for years and years to come. It's a process we are deeply involved in. It's a process that you all, as SIFMA members, have an opportunity and a responsibility to be part of. We know what we need to do. Help us get it done for the sake of our industry, for the sake of our economy, and our country. Only by working together can we maximize the chances that we will, in fact, get this right. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been an honor to have served as your chair-elect at this critical time in the history of our industry and to have worked with a board as knowledgeable and dedicated as the SIFMA board and with a staff as capable and committed as that of Tim Ryan and the SIFMA team. Thank you very much.